This conference will now be recorded.
Okay. Okay. So last time we discussed about the business partner. So I was about to show you how the business partner can be created in S/4HANA system. So that time we have a problem in system. So I will show you a business partner, how I can create a business partner. Okay. So BP is the transaction to create a business partner. Okay. So you will see whenever you go into the screen BP transaction, you will see maintain business partner as a person or as an organization or as a group. Okay. Normally we will not use this group for S/4HANA system. We will use only a person and organization. Group is useful in IS utilities or IS media, all this IS industry specific solutions. Okay, for time being, we will ignore the group creation. We will create only organization and person as a categories. Okay, just click on the organization. So immediately you will get the business partner with what role you want to create and what is the validity of this and what is a grouping. Okay, so here grouping is the number range. So this is similar to your XGN1. Okay, so we have seen the grouping is nothing but it's a number range for your business partner, whether you want to give an external number range or internal number range. So that is a called as a grouping. So this grouping I will show you in SPRO. This is under a cross application component, business partners. Okay, so we have this business partner and number ranges and grouping. So we need to define the number range and assign the number ranges to the grouping. It is not specific to any business partner role. Okay, you can take it freely, any kind of a business partner grouping. So I will just define one number range. So this you can define either it's internal number range or external number range. So it doesn't matter. So I can define one for say, for example, I will define judged. It is for 501701. Okay, 701 I can take, I think 801 I will take. Okay, I've taken this 801 and one number range I have just created as ZZ. Now what I need to do, I need to go back and create one group, define groups. So I can take one group here. I will just create, say, business partner ZZ. Grouping for business partner is okay. And we have defined this as a ZZ. Okay, so I have defined one number range and I have defined one grouping and assigned the number range to the grouping. So that means we are ready for using this number range against the business partner creation. So now what I need to do, I'll go here. So the moment I create a grouping here, it should appear here. Okay. So just see ZP ZZ, BP ZZ. I will run this, I will refresh the screen, BP, organization. See, grouping for a business partner. So this is what we have created. So immediately I need to enter the number range. Why? Because in the configuration, I just say BPZZ is internal. Okay, so the moment I set it's external, so that means I can create an external number range. I can assign the number range while I'm creating a business partner. But here I didn't say external, so it will automatically take as an internal. So what is this internal and external? So we know that internal and external, but what is this internal standard grouping and external standard grouping? So what does it mean? When I am creating a business partner, okay, when I am creating a business partner, say for example, I am creating a business partner using some third party systems. Okay, so the moment I create a customer and it should come to the CRM system or currently your ECC system or UWM system. So that time in the Excel sheet, you will mention, okay, I need an internal number to be created, or in the program, you will mention, I want external number to be created. So you are not specifying what number it should take. So in that case, it will come here and automatically, if it is internal, it will take this. If it is external, this will take, it will take this. You will see only one internal and one external in the whole configuration. You cannot have multiple externals and multiple internals. So is this clear for you? Is this clear for you?
Santosh, internal number, it's anyway, it will take from the what you just maintained, and from external, from where it picks up?
Normally, when I create a business partner, external is you need to enter. Yeah. See, for example, I am choosing this BP01. So this was okay. Set as an external here. Right? Okay. See, for example, BP01, it was set as an external. So that means you need to provide it. That is 103. Okay. So this is the number I'm giving. Okay.
Okay.
If it is external, the system will automatically take it.
Yeah. Yeah. So the normal. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I will just enter this business partner test. We'll put test as 2. Okay. So here some mandatory fields will be there, so that we will discuss how it is controlled. So let's say I will maintain it for Germany. Okay. And language, what is the language you want to maintain the customer? So this you can do. And also the address, as I said, when we are discussing about the business partner, we can maintain the business partner in multiple addresses. Like we can create address for correspondence, home address, business address, holiday address. So like this, I can create a multiple addresses for a business partner, which is not possible in the ECC. This is additional advantage. Okay. And along with that one, we also have a validity period. So that means in the first screen of my business partner, I am entering the number because my grouping says it's an external number range and the business partner role. Okay. So here, one thing is, okay, so here important point to note is when I create a business partner, okay, so I will be having a business partner role. So that is what I told you, we have a business partner role. So each and every business partner is controlled with a role. So what is this role and how the role is controlling, that we will see configuration. But by default, all my general data will be with will be having a BP role called business partner general by default. Okay, so you when I want to create a business partner address, so system will automatically take this as by default. You know, no need to create anything, it will be by default coming. Okay, so the first point is, our first business partner role is general letter. Okay, so what is the role for this general letter? So we are using this general letter role. It always will contain the address. Okay, I will save this. Now I have saved the business partner 1023. So next is, I will extend this business partner to my sales and distribution, or I will extend this business partner for purchasing, or I will extend this for some other modules, or for ETM, or for EWM, for GTS, wherever you want, you can extend. How do I extend? Go to the change mode and change in the business partner role. So this is already created. So you need to say, okay, for for example, I want to create a business partner in SG module. So for SG, we have a standard business partner roles, FLCU00, okay, or FLCU01. This is for FI postings and this is for SD postings. So this is for manual JVs or your FI transactions, and this is for a customer in SD module. So we will see, where do you configure this. So that means, first of all, I will go to the business partner role, and immediately when I choose this business partner role, the system will give you a sales and distribution module and ATM module. Okay, so this role is configured for SD as well as ATM. Okay, so we will see what is this role and how it is controlled. But first of all, I will go into this business partner, and what I need to do, I need to go to the sales and distribution, and I need to enter this business partner is creating under which sales organization. Normally in your XT01 also, you will create a customer master and you will maintain it for sales organization, right? Under which sales organization I need to enter this. Similar way you are doing it. Okay, so just I will enter some data. And if you want any delivery priority or the customer pricing procedure, these are all common. There is no change in the customer pricing procedure or statistics wherever. However you are creating it in the ECC, the same way you are creating here. Additionally, you have one column or one tab called the relevant for settlement management. So this we will discuss when we are talking about the rebate management. So I will come to the shipping, and there are no changes in this. Okay, these are all by default. You will get a sold to ship to, payer, and bill to. Okay, any additional data, all the additional data fields are here. Okay, and
box. So where would be the shipping condition? Can you show in shipping, please? Shipping condition.
Yeah, here we have shipping condition.
Okay.
And we can have the status which you are doing in either XG05 or XG06. Customer text, we can enter all the text here. Okay, any additional data, you can enter the additional data. I will just save this and we will see what will happen. Okay, required entries not missing. So I think in the general entry, general data, some field is mandatory. So we will see what is this mandatory field. Yeah. So postal code is mandatory, 560100. And I will say it's a Munich. Okay, I maintain this data. I'm saving now. It says customer master data could not be updated. See long text. Okay, that we will see later. Now I have created a customer. Now just go to the change mode, and if you want to see to which roles this customer is extended, we can just click on this and you will see I have created a business partner as a general data and as a FLCU01. Okay, so now in the same way I can go and extend this to FLCU00. This is for my accounting purpose, manual JV postings or your accounting clearance and all. You need a customer to be created under the company code. So the moment I choose the business partner as FL00, the system will automatically prompt you to enter the company code data. Just click on the company code data, and you can either create a company code data like this, or you can enter the company code data here. So what is your company code? I will just put 1010 or 1001. Okay, if I want to extend for multiple company codes, I can extend like this. 1010. Okay, whether you want a customer to be created or not. So just say adopt. What is the reconciliation account? You can find out the reconciliation. So I will check. Okay, so here, any other details from the CO, your FI and CO point of view, you can just enter your payment terms, your dunning methodology, your insurance, customs statuses, all these things you can do it here. Okay, so one simple way of extending the customer to the company code and sales organization is done, can be done here using a business partner. It's not like you need to go to XG01, copy from existing customer or existing sales organization or existing company code. So these are all not required. You can just enter the company code, whichever company code you want, you can just create and adapt. That's all. So is it clear? Is it clear for you?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just now saving this. Okay, so general data is still missing. So that means for financial accounting also, there's some mandatory field. It should be a language. Yes. Okay, language is missing. I just copied the language. So I have created a business partner as customer. As a business partner, general address, customer address, and company code address. So now I want to see how many business partners are to which business partner role I have extended my business partner. We can come here and see always. So it is now created as a general customer for FI and customer for SD. Okay, so we understand like, when I create a business partner for a customer, I am doing it for FLCU00. And what is the significance of it? So if you observe clearly, when I extend the business partner to the customer, so system is prompting me to enter some mandatory fields, right? So I have not entered the postal code in city. I got a message saying that these two are mandatory fields. But the moment when I click on the company code, it is asking for language also. So language is a mandatory at the company code. So that means how my business partner field status is controlled. So before we go to the field status, first of all, we will see what is there in the business partner role. Okay. So if I go to the configuration, business partner roles. So always remember, in the standard also, nobody will ask you to change or nobody will ask you to configure the business partner roles. You can use the standard roles only. Okay. So we have a standard roles such as FLCU00. Okay. This is for FI customer and this is for your SD customer. FLVN00 is for supplier and FI, and this is FLVN01 is for normal. And financial services is FS00. So always use only the standard settings, unless and until if there is a customer requirement and you discuss with the business. If he is not accepting, then you can just go and create a new one. You in that time also just copy the existing business partner rules. You cannot create on your own. Why? Because when I create a business partner on my own, sometimes there will be a lot of internal settings that we need to configure. So like this data may be missing. Okay, so that is the reason you always just copy the business partner using this and create your own. So this is a title for FI customer and you set the business partner role category and this is a view. So this view will control what data to be, what tabs should come. Okay, so that is the reason you always need to copy it. Okay, don't make any changes to the standard one, and you know that it's a SAP created one. So always you copy using a FL00, and if you want to customize anything, always better to copy it, or you know to make lot of other settings also. Okay, so here we are using a FL00, and we have a role category. So what is this role category? Okay, I will show you. We have discussed on the role, BP role called FLCU00 or FLCU01. Okay, this is my FI customer role, and this is for my SD role. And also we have FLVN00 and FLVN01. This is for my supplier for FI, and this is for purchasing. So I have created my business partner. Okay, I have extended business partner under general data, and next to customer, FI customer and SD customer. So in the business partner role category, you are seeing a role category, right? Under the role, we are seeing a BP role category. Okay. So what is this role category? What it plays? What is the significance of this role category? So BP role. Okay, BP role to BP role category. BP role to BP role category is always one-to-one relation. BP role to BP role category is always one-to-one. So that means I can create one role and assign only one role category. In the same way, BP role category to BP role is I can extend this to many. Are you getting this point? So one role will have only one role category, but one role category will have can be assigned to multiple roles. So that means just say I have a role category, BP role category as FLCU, say for example, get FLCU. Okay, BP role, we have FLCU00, right, and FLCU01, FLBN00, FLBN01. For all of these, I can assign only one role categories. Okay. So for FLCU00, I can assign FLCU, ZFLCU, and FLCU01 also, I can extend ZFLCU. So like this, whatever the role categories you think can have a common data or common fields can be created with a one role category. Is this clear for you? Hello?
What is the importance of role category? Sandhya?
Yeah, that I will come. Role category I will come. So within this roles and role categories, role category will have a major importance. So that means it's at a macro level, and role category is assigned to different roles. So all my field statuses, so role category will control field status.
Okay, got it.
And also the role category will control the CVI integration. So we will discuss on what is the CVI integration. So, but now we have a different role categories and we have a different roles. So if you think of controlling the role or field status based on the role, so that means you know to make everything specific to your role, and we can also control the role field status based on the role category. So that means if I make at a one place, it will impact all the roles which are assigned to this role category. So that means role category will control the field status of your business partner. So now if I come to this, previously we have an option when I'm creating a FI customer, okay, system prompt me to enter the language as which is a mandatory. Right, this is a mandatory field which is missing, and system prompted me to enter this mandatory field. But when I creating, when I'm creating the SD customer, okay, the postal code and city, these are all missing. Do you see that? Do you identify it? Maybe what we can do, I'll just create one more customer for you. Okay, 1024, I'm taking this. I will be entering this. Okay, so this is FLCU00. I am going to the customer. Okay, so if you see here, the financial customer field statuses are missing. Postal code, maybe I will come from, I will come from FLCU01. Okay, new customer. Okay, so this is test customer. Just come here. See, I have a postal code in city. I have a city and country. Okay, but I don't see the language as mandatory. Now in the next screen or separate screen, I will open. So now I'm using FLCU as a financial customer, and there is also one more called as, just see, can you able to see the two screens?
Yes, yes.
See, we have maybe I'll extend this, I'll close this. Okay, so this is my customer. 1025 is already existing. I will just see it 1026. So the name is mandatory, that is fine. And after the name, we can see here, postal code is mandatory, right? So I will enter the postal code, city is mandatory, and country is mandatory. Now you can see here, language is also mandatory. So that means my BP role, FLCU01, it's for new, it's SD customer. You can see here, right? Sales and distribution. And this is for company code. Are you getting the point here? When I enter the FLCU00 as customer for financial purpose, I'm getting some different fields as a mandatory. When I enter FLCU01 for SD customer, I'm getting different fields for mandatory settings. So what we understand, or what is the inference we can draw, is the BP role is controlling. At this point of a time, I can understand, okay, BP role, based on the BP role, the field status is controlling. Okay, exactly. If I go to the configuration, the BP role FLCU00 is assigned to FLCU00. But FLCU01, if I click on this and see, it is assigned to FLCU01. So that means, we can understand, okay, business partner role is controlling the field statuses. And inside the business partner role, there is also one more macro level, it is called as a business partner role category. So if I make any changes to the role category, for example, what I will do is, I will make this to FLCU00. Okay, so we will see testing. I have now FLCU01, which is assigned to the role category FLCU00. And also FLCU00, I have FLCU00. So now what I did for both, I gave only one role category to understand which is controlling, whether it's controlled by role category or role. Now I will come here and I will go to the business partner role again. Okay. This is a test. I'm going to FLCU00 is FI customer, create, Okay, so now you can see mandatory field. This is a mandatory field, this is a mandatory field. What I will do, I will go to, I will come out without saving. I will extend this to FLCU01. Okay, so even for new customer, SD customer also, it should queue. Why it is not queuing? FLCU01. Did not save this field. Slash and business partner. Okay, I will come here, organization. I will choose this FLCU01 for new customer. This is for new, for FI. So we have sent FLCU00 for this, and this is with the additional file FLCU00. Just taking 1024. Okay, address data. Okay, I'm into the address data FLCU00. Okay, FLCU00 is asking for mandatory field. Okay, when I go with the FLCU01. Is not asking FLCU01 what is the role we have sent. Okay, I will come to this. So normally we have this configuration for field statuses, where the configuration is field grouping. Okay, so we can do it based on the business partner role. Okay, just click on this role category will be there internally. So what is my role FLCU00? Okay, is a business partner role, is based on the business partner role also we have, and FLCU01 also we have. So what I can do, I will see the address. So in this address we have a language, external address, this is postal code is mandatory and the city is mandatory. So we will see the language. Yeah, language was set as optional here. This is for FLCU customer. Okay, FLCU00. Now I'm going into this. So I will click on this. Okay, so the optional, this is the optional. They put the language here. We will see the language. Yeah, language was set as a mandatory here. So here in this place we are using only the roles. Okay, not a role category. So here we have a four options. One is as a client level. So without creating any role category, we can control the field status. So that means at the client level, if I say, so this is at a business partner level. Okay. So that means when I use a BP transaction, it will be automatically set for all the business partner roles, irrespective of a role. So that means I can set this as a mandatory irrespective of any kind of a role. So that is a business partner level, this client level. Okay, but it is not the correct solution because we may require reconciliation accounts, or we may require some dunning for FA customers which are not mandatory for SD customers. So that's why before you go for the implementation, you just make sure whether you are having the same business partner field status for all the business partner in common, or you can ask the client whether you want the field status to be controlled based on the role categories or roles. So this is what you need to do, and this is a roles based on the roles. You can also control this based on the roles. Okay. Next is we can also control based on the BP role types. BP role type is BP partner type. So we have a partner field here in this business partner. So when I go with the 1024, say for example, when I create a new partner, okay, so here control, I can have a BP role type, business partner type. Okay, so now instead of controlling based on the BP role type or BP role category, I can also control based on the BP type, business partner type. So that configuration also we have field statuses based on the role types. Okay, so some roles I can set some roles as a mandatory and some roles as optional. So these are all the screens. Yeah, these are all the screens, field status screens. And when I come here for sold to, say for example, I want something for sold to. So some fields I can set mandatory, and for some fields I can set as a optional. So role category will be the first option, and next is business partner type. So either you can play at a role category level or your business partner type level. So but the advantages will be with a role, it will be common, it will be only specific for that role. So when I say I am creating a customer with a role as FLCU00, so that means my customer is for sales and distribution, and I also have for FI. So for both of these, I need a different roles, or I need a different field statuses. So in such case, it is better to have with a role category level. If you say at a client level, it will be common across the system, irrespective of your role. So that means when I create a business partner, either it can be a FI customer or SD customer or supplier or FI supplier, it doesn't matter. It will be common. So that means the reconciliation account will come for FI customer as well as the SD customer, which is not correct, right? So that is the reason you need to check and you need to give options to the customer, to the client, saying we have these many options, and as per the standard, either we can go with the BP partner type or BP role category. Okay, this is the field status grouping. So next is in the business partner, I have one more option here, BP roles. So what is this BP role? It's a BP, we have a FLCU01. Okay, I have a role category here. So what is my role category? FLCU00. So that is my role, right? FA customer. So if I click on this, I can say whether this customer can be created as an organization or as a person or as a group. So what does it mean? So when I click on this business partner role category, the system will let you know to under which category the system, the customer or the business partner can be created. So let's say, for example, I am using a FLCU00. It's my FI customer. I will go to the business partner here. Okay, it's a BP transaction. I will create organization. So I want to choose this FLCU00. This is my FI customer. I will say create. Okay, I can create it. But same thing, I want to create under the person, whether system will allow or not, we will see. FLCU01. Just see FL. Do you find FLCU00 here or FLCU01? We have FLVN, but FLC is not there, right? Starting with F, we have only two, supplier and financial supplier, but we don't have a customer. Our FLCU0, FI customer is not there, and the same way FI normal SD customer is also not there. Why? Because I am controlling this under the role categories. So same thing, if I go to FLCU00, so I can create on all the three. So that is the reason we are getting the three options when I want to choose the role category as FLCVN00. So I can create a customer as an organization or as a person, but that is controlled again by the BP role category. So that means BP role category will control the whether the customer has to be created as an organizational category or as a personal category. So what is this person and organization is? If you are selling a material to the customer or if you are buying something from a vendor, so either he can be an individual person or he can be a corporate or a group, right? So there will be a contact person or there can be a sales employees who are individuals. So always the individuals, contact person, sales employees or technicians or repair personnel, all these employees, these has to be created as a person. So when I click on the person, there can be some fields which are not mandatorily, automatically they will be set as a hided out. So it means some fields which are not required specific to that person will not be displayed for us. So that's why, that is the reason you need to choose whether you want to create as a person or as an organization. Okay. And also we have a relationship. So I can assign relationship to organization and the person. Or person to organization. Okay, so business partner role category, the second thing is it controls the whether the business partner has to be created as a person or as an organization. So this is the second important thing. So next is, if I come here,
I'm sorry Santosh, you are telling about relationship. What important that relationship in BP role?
Yeah, relationship. I will come to the relationship. So relationship is basically, I will show you one relationship. So let's say I'm creating a business partner here. Okay, I have a FLCU00. I have a customer. I'll create the customer. Okay, so this is my mandatory fields. So I will control the mandatory fields here. So when I will save this customer. So next is, I want to create a contact person. In ECC, how do you create a contact person? Contact person is specific to customer, right? So we will go to VAP1 transaction and we are creating a contact person. So we will see whether we can use the same VAP1 here or not. Okay, so this is my contact person. So what I will be having here is, I need to go give the 1024 as my customer. Okay, so what is this it's showing to you? It is giving redirecting to the transaction BP as VAP1 is obsolete. So it means we cannot use VAP1 in the S4HANA system. It will go to BP. Automatically, you can create this BP as person. See, can you see here, this automatically creates as a person. Okay, I have this VA01 BP transaction as 1021, and I want to find out this relationship category is BUP contact person, has a contact person. I need to define the relationship like this. 1024 has a contact person. Who is that contact person? We can create anything. Okay, so this 1022 is my contact person to 1024. Okay, now I will save this. I have saved it. Now what I will do, I will go to BP1022. I want to see what is 1022. I will open this 1022. Okay, 1022 is what? General data. You can go to the general data. And this was created as contact person. And under the role, BUP001. So if I want to create a business partner as a contact person, he should be created under the role as BUP001. Okay, and the relationship, if I click on the relationship here, it shows he is a contact person to 1024 and 1025. So when I click on the business partner, so he will be a contact person for 1024 business partner and 1021 business partner. Okay, it's not only for contact person. We can create this relationship for sales employees or create managers or create representatives, your technicians, MRS consultants, all those things has to be created under here only. If I click on the overview here, so you can create all those things. He's a guardian, he's a child, create manager, create representatives, invoicing party, employee responsible. All those things we can create as your service provider. Okay, all those things you can create as a relationship. Okay, your great manager.
Santosh, one question.
Yeah.
Can we see this contact person or employee representative in our customer in SD in partner function level?
We don't have a customer, right? We are not using XG02 here anyhow.
No, not XG02. If you're going in this business partner only, in SD,
yeah, we are seeing
customer level.
For example, this is my contact person. Right,
yeah.
I have assigned this to 1024. This is my business partner.
Yeah,
if I click on this business partner, if I go to 1024 here, okay, I can see under the relationship he has a contact person as 1022. So, what is this 1024? 1024 is a business partner which you created under the FI customer.
Yeah.
So you have a different question?
Yeah, suppose an example, if I have a multiple shift of parties, where I can see that? For a solo party, if I would have a multiple shift of parties or employee representatives, where I can see those?
Okay, see, for example,
you
I
understand
have,
my point.
I will show you. Okay, so I have created a customer. Okay, this is my FI customer, SG customer. Now FLCU001, this is my customer. I have created a customer under the sales and distribution. Okay, I can go to the business partner here. All those business partners will be available. If you want to assign another shift to party, okay, so you can assign, say for example 1024 is, or you can assign 1001. So whoever you created as a business partner can be assigned here. It is not required that he should be created under one accounting group, not like our SD. You can create a business partner if he is created as a business partner under FLCU01. He can be added as a ship to, sold to, bill to, payer, whatever it is.
Oh, super. No, okay. What I'm asking is, well, we are creating an SH. We don't need to give the particular business role, like how we are going to account group in system.
We need a role. Always the customer has to be treated as
FLCC001. Okay. FLCC001 only.
Yeah, I have created a ship to 1024. I will try to add. So what will do? System is saying that he has not created under the
sales area.
So why he has not created? Because we have not extended this to FLCU00. Extended only for year 0, but not 01.
Yes. And also like that, can we add here employee representative or contact person, broker here in partner function, or no need? Just I add
always a contact person always has to be added from a relationship only. We cannot add directly here.
Oh, got it. No, in ECC system where I can find that employee representative, contact person, all in partner functions level. That's the reason I asked.
Yeah, correct. There we have option, but here we don't have such option because we are creating different specific to roles.
Yeah, no need. I mean to say, definitely we are contacting directly from the business partner role. Why we need to go to the customer? Yeah, understood.
Right.
Thank you.
And also, the contact person is created in a different role altogether. A different role. And even employee also will be created as a different partner role. So
yes.
This partner functions when I create or when I assign anything here, always it has to be created under FLC01 only, or else it will not allow you to close.
Yes. Okay. Thank you.
So that is the reason we have a relationship.
Okay. So what about ETM data, Santosh?
This is for equipment tools management. We have a linear asset management. Asset management, PM plant maintenance. So this is a topic in the ETM.
Okay.
So it's basically of enterprise asset management, EAM. So there is one module which talks about the services, plant maintenance, customer service, linear asset management, your workflow management. All those things will deal with the ETM tools, ETM data.
Yeah, so in real time, actually BP roles only from user end they will create, right? I mean, as standard for implementation or something. User roles, some master data team is separately they maintain for this BP, right? Is it from our end also? Can we respond for this actually?
You are talking about the ETM.
Not on whole BP business model, like
yeah, BP is basically a business data. It's like your customer and vendor, how your customer and vendor is now maintained, the same way business partner is also maintained in the S/4HANA system. It's a responsibility of your business model.
Responsibility
of business team. So there will
business
be a business,
one, yeah, business team. Correct. Yeah, business team only, correct.
Santosh, his question is nowadays to change any master address, the MDM team will be taking care of that.
Yeah, correct.
This is the reason any like particular restricted to MDM team, or we can do if
same MDM. It is done by MDM team. Even if in S/4HANA also, we have a separate MDM master data team. But currently in 1709, MDM is not part of 1709. It is coming in 1809 in the next month. Okay, as per the roadmap. So we have a lot of new changes in the 1809. So MDM is also part of this 1809 and VC variant configuration. Yeah, we have lot many other simple logistics models will be embedded.
Okay. Am I correct, Arif, with your question is asking to Santosh?
Yeah, that is correct actually. Yeah, real time actually in customer master we can we are not involved in any creation of this.
Yeah, creation we are not involved. Basically the master data team, our consultant work is, we need to make sure that business partners are smoothly created in the systems, all the configuration setup we need to do. Okay. And say, for example, we are talking about a CVA integration, which in the further classes, we will talk about the CVA. So that means when I create a business partner in the backend, the customer or vendor or whatever the business partner we want, it should create automatically in the backend. Okay. That setup we need to do. So the syncing process to customer and business partner it will be done. So once you do the setup, automatically the day-to-day MDM team can go and create business partners and customers. So our responsibility only to set up the system.
Yeah.
Okay. And also we have a Fury apps. Okay, Fury apps are nothing but it's a GUI, another graphical user interface, you know what you are using currently. But you also have a Fury apps with user experience. So that means you can access the data anywhere, not only at laptop. You no need to sit at lap before the laptop. You can do it from mobile. It can be compatible for any kind of a device. So that also I will show you once we complete the business partner. So I will show you how I can create a business partner using a Fury apps. So this is all
so
our responsibility to set up.
Sorry. Same way where we have created an ECC, the same way we need to configure in Fury apps also.
Fury app is a front end. What we are doing here is in the S4HANA system. This is my back end system, but Fury app is my front end system, like your GUI.
Correct. Okay. No, same configuration can we do in the same Fury apps also? Like how it will go such a way?
No, I didn't get your question. Maybe just I will.
Santosh, what he's asking is, do we need to separately need to configure for Fury applications or same configurations where we can use in Fury?
It's a front end for us. So when you are creating any sales, your sales order or your customer, how you are getting currently, it's an easy access, right? You go to the XG01 or you go to the BP transaction or you go to MK01 or XK01. So that is your front end currently in the GUI. So we have two systems. One is a front end system and back end system. Back end system where you do all the configurations. Front end can be Fury or it can be GUI. Are you getting this point, Arif?
Yeah, I mean, is there any connection between back-end and front-end? I mean, is there any through transport? Once we have done transport configuration from ECC, then we need to transport to Fury app like that. The data will be passed to Fury app, like we don't have, right?
No, no.
Actually.
You are in the ECC system, right?
Yes.
You are able to see
yeah.
my sharing? You are in the ECC
yeah,
system
yeah.
currently. Okay. Yes. So you did the SG configuration for customer master using SPRO. You will go to the FICO customers. You will be doing OBD2. You will be assigning the XE and one OBS.
Yeah.
So this configuration you did. Where did you do this configuration? You did this configuration in the SPRO screen.
SPRO, yeah.
Correct. And after that, you will call XG01 transaction. And you will assign the account group or account assignment, or what is the account group you want to create, and you will create. This is what XG01 or XK01 or BD01, these are all your front ends, GUI screens. Do you agree? Do you agree?
Yeah, yes.
This is your GUI. It's nothing but your end user transactions.
Yes.
Okay, easy access. Maybe I can say in other words, it's an easy access screen where you do all end user transactions. You are not doing,
correct.
You are not calling it as a SPRO. So now, same thing, we are doing all the settings in the S4HANA system. Instead of doing everything in the ECC, once we move to the S4HANA system, we will make all the settings here in the S4HANA systems. So we'll call this as a CVI or business partner configuration. So we have a GUI also. Instead of using XG01, I will call this BP. Parallel to the GUI, I have a Fury apps. Okay, so instead of calling this BP, I will call the app as create business partner. Okay, so this is similar to your Book My Show or IRCTC app, so there is no confusion. GUI and Fury apps are currently parallel, but going forward, we will not have the GUI. It will be only depend on the Furies.
Huh, correct.
Configuration is same. So whether you are calling a BP or whether you are creating using an app, the backend configuration will come only from this S4HANA SPRO.
Ha ha. In today's session, you have created a BP, nothing but a Azure master or sales customer or something, okay?
Yes.
So same configuration can we do again in Fiori apps also? That is my question.
No, configuration is not required to do. It is only one time. It will be only a master data we are creating in the Fiori. Fiori app is like, it is only for end user transactions, not for configuration.
Oh, sorry. No, it's not configuration, correct. Okay, correct.
Okay. So where you are creating a business partner in the GUI using a XG01 or BP transaction, the same thing you can also use in the Fiori also. That is what the backend configuration would remain same in the Fiori in your S4HANA system. So you are not supposed to create any, because Fiori is not supposed to do any configuration. It's only for end user transactions.
Yeah. Okay. So business partner roles or categories. So these are all things. So it's going to configuration in the GUI. Once we have configuration, we need to go in Fiori apps, so then create a business partner. That's it.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
So tomorrow you are going to show Fiori apps or right now?
Tomorrow we have a CVA integration. So currently we have created only a business partner and we extended this to the sales and distribution. But It should allow us to create a sales order also, because we have not created XG01, right? We have to see how my business partner will be entered into the KNVB table, KNV1, KNA1 table, or KNB1. We just added the role to specific module SG or FI, but we need to ensure this also to be created, entered in this tables. So we have a CVA, that sync we need to do tomorrow. So that means I have created only a business partner and extended this to role, but I need to ensure that this role is creating and updating the tables. I will show you tomorrow how I can sync. So later on, okay, we'll go to the business partner in Fiori.
The same tables, so the data will be updated in, I know, in existing tables like VBAK, VBAP, VBP, or is there any other specific tables relevant?
Yeah, some changes are there in the table level also. But first of all, we will see only the customer master, and then later we'll go to the other master data tables. Okay, so I will go slow by slow, step by step. You don't get confused, because business partner is the main topic. If you get a confusion in business partner, this confusion will lead for great management, your sales transactions, your MM transactions, everything. So make sure you are completely understanding the business partner. We will spend more time on the business partner unless you are completely clear on this, because this is the main topic. If you are saying, if you're still having a confusion, so this confusion will lead to other till the end.
Yeah, it's fine, but no issues. Okay.
So tomorrow we will see with the CVI integration, and then later we will go with the CV, the business partner under the Furies.
Okay,
just practice. Once you practice now, you will get a lot of questions.
Correct. But
Suresh, you
please send me the link, the server link.
The server, I'll send the person name to you. We can directly send a mail asking him the server. The same server, you'll get it. Okay, I will send you that link, the name of the person.
Okay.
Sir, you are some friend, Joga Rao, he called me.
Joginder.
Yeah, he didn't join.
Yeah.
Maybe can you check tomorrow?
No. Joginder is transferring from Chennai to Hyderabad, sorry, Chennai to Bangalore in another week. He will join later. He wants weekends classes.
Yeah.
And also, three more guys are there: Uday Kumar, Rama Devi, and Nagaraj Naik. These three guys are looking for a weekends match. That's the reason I thought to put into the weekend match. Let's see, I will discuss with them, but they are not able to attend. They are working, the companies are too far. They can't attend in morning session. That's the reason they are looking for the weekend session, but they are interested.
Okay,
If you are arranging any weekend session, we can tell them to attend the weekend session either Saturday or Sunday.
Okay, we can plan, or else you can just ask them to call me. So based on their flexibility, we will plan accordingly.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I'll tell them.